Good morning students, today our topic will be class 12th biology chapter 4 reproductive health and in that sexually transmitted diseases. So sexually transmitted diseases are those infections that are transferred from one person to another person through the sexual intercourse. So if one person is suffering from any kind of sexually transmitted infection in the reproductive tract, so that person can transfer the infection to the another healthy person through the medium of sex. So in this, these diseases are also known by other names like venereal diseases, reproductive tract infections, RTIs. Venereal diseases because of related to the goddess of love called Venus. So therefore venereal disease. Examples. So these are the examples. Some of them are bacterial disease, some of them are viral disease, some of them are protozoan diseases. Like gonorrhea, syphilis, these are bacterial disease. So gonorrhea and syphilis, these are bacterial disease. And gonorrhea is caused by Neisseria gonorrhea bacterium and syphilis is caused by Treponema pallidum bacterium. Genital herpes is caused by herpes simplex virus type 1, type 2 and chlamydiasis. So this genital herpes is a viral disease. So herpes simplex virus type 1, type 2 causes genital herpes. There are sores on the genital areas. There are bumps on the skin. Lesions are there in this case of the genital herpes. Chlamydiasis is caused by the bacteria again, Chlamydia trachomatis bacteria, and genital warts, or we can say big patchy lesions on the skin called as genital warts are caused by a virus called as papilloma virus. This is also a viral disease, genital warts. Chlamydiasis is bacteria. So trachomoniasis is caused by protozoan. It is a flagellated protozoan. So flagellated protozoan is trachomoniasis. Trachomoniasis is caused by Trachomonas vaginalis. It's a flagellated protozoan. Hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is caused by hepatitis virus B, and this is also again virus. And AIDS is caused by again a virus called as human immunodeficiency virus, HIV. This HIV life cycle will be studied in detail in the chapter, which is the health chapter, coming in the health and human diseases chapter. Now mode of transmission. How these diseases are transferred from one person to another person? So in this, sexual contact of any type means any type of sexual contact. If two persons come in the close contact directly to each other, one person is suffering from the disease, even then that person is not having any symptoms, but still if that person is carrying the organisms for the disease, can transfer those organisms to another person. So anal sex, vaginal sex and oral sex, all of these are causing the transfer of body fluids from one person to another. That is why from those body fluids the infection can go to another person. Sharing of injections and needles. So if person is sharing the needles, then the person through the blood transfer can occur. The needle carries some of the blood in its syringe, so that if same syringe or needle is used for another person, the infection can go by this means. Sharing of unsterilized surgical instruments. If same, this again, if we have not broken the needle of the same used syringe, that and that is same is used to another person, then also the infection can go. Transfusion of blood, that means in some of the diseases like in hemophilia, thalassemia, blood transfer to the patient is necessary. So in that case, if a person is having infected blood and if that blood is not properly detected or diagnosed for any kind of diseases and is directly or in the case of emergency, for example, if a person met an accident, then large amount of blood is needed for transfer. So in that case, if person suddenly get a transfer from a donor and that donor is carrying any disease, so other person will also carry that disease. So infected mother to fetus, some of the infection can go from the mother, pregnant mother, to their babies also through this means. Note, except the viral disease like hepatitis B, genital herpes and HIV, these three are not curable. They are, we can say, no cure are there for them. Out of which hepatitis B vaccines are available. In the childhood, the person get vaccinated for hepatitis B, and genital herpes and HIV are uncurable diseases, so they takes a toll on the life of the patient and they ultimate is the death is there. And other diseases except these three are curable, means the person is diagnosed of trichomoniasis, chlamydiasis, of any other disease like genital warts or gonorrhea and syphilis, they can be treated by the medication, by the prescription of certain drugs and tablets through which their patient can be cured. Symptoms. What are the common symptoms of these STD? Is itching all over the genital area, fluid discharge from the penis or vagina, and foul smelling discharges from the reproductive tracts. Pain in pelvic abdomen region. The abdomen region, the region which is below the chest, gets pain, and genital areas also get pain. Pain during sex is also experienced when person suffer from the diseases. STDs can remain asymptomatic in females because female reproductive tracts are hidden inside their pelvic region. They are not outside the body. So in them, the symptoms also remain asymptomatic for large amount of time. And but they can later stage, it can, if remain undiagnosed, can lead to abortion, stillbirths, deaths, stillbirth means aborted child, aborted pregnancy, infertility and cancer also. Later stage, they can, female can become infertile also, they can suffer from cancer also. Preventions. What are the preventions? If person is diagnosed with any kind of STD, the person should avoid the sex, abstain from sex for that particular time until which he or she is not cured. Then avoid the sex with unknown multiple partner. Casual sex should be avoided completely. Multiple partner sex also should be avoided completely. And always using condoms during sex. So mechanical barrier method, using that method or covering the reproductive tract through latex made condoms can we can say prevent the STDs. And getting complete treatment after getting diagnosed. If you are suffering from or detected of any of the STD, so you should get proper treatment till the last step so that you get completely cured of that STD. So I hope this STD portion is clear to you. In the next video, we will study about the topic infertility. You have to make notes on this topic. You can study, you can add points from NCERT, or you can add from points from the reference book. Thank you.